Here we are in 2022, and you and I probably both know that gas-powered cars and internal combustion engines are kind of on their way out, and they're being replaced by electric vehicles. We're seeing this trend across markets, from sedans, pickup trucks, motorcycles, planes, and even into the commercial market with semi-trucks. Really, it's only a matter of time until the internal combustion engine just dies. Or at least that's what I thought until Yamaha and Toyota dropped some news the other day, which is their co-development of a 5-liter V8 engine. Now, what made this particular 5-liter V8 engine special was the fact that it was powered by hydrogen rather than gasoline or diesel, which means it has zero emissions output at all. And better yet, it sounds absolutely amazing and makes a ton of power. So sit down, relax, and get comfy, because today I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about this new 5-liter hydrogen-powered V8 from Toyota and Yamaha. So to start this off, I want to make it perfectly clear that Toyota really did not do this on their own, and they had to rely heavily on Yamaha for this. Now you might be wondering, Yamaha? Why them of all companies? Yamaha, it's the company that sells everything. Like, hey, I want to buy a piano. Oh, I can help you with that. Oh, I also want to buy a motorcycle. Do you know where I can buy one? You're not going to believe this, but I can help you with that too. It sounds kind of crazy, but it actually makes sense because Toyota and Yamaha actually have a long-standing relationship. They've worked together numerous times over the last few decades. Some of you might remember the LFA, which is Lexus's supercar that really never took off and cost Toyota so much money to develop that each one was sold at a net loss rather than a profit. Yamaha helped Toyota with the development of the V10 under the hood of the LA. But if you go back even further, you'll see that Yamaha and Toyota worked together on the 1JZ. Now, there's people all over the internet that claim that the 2JZ was also co-developed between Yamaha and Toyota, but there's no actual proof of this claim anywhere, although the 2JZ head is very similar to the 1JZ head that Yamaha was involved with. Anyways, you can actually go back even further than that, all the way to the 1960s, when Toyota and Yamaha worked together on the 2000 GT. This isn't a video about their long-standing relationship, so I won't go into more detail, but simply put, they have worked together a bunch, and it made sense in this context. Although this new 5-liter engine made a ton of news, and it's very interesting and cool, it's not actually a new concept for Toyota at all. In fact, they've been playing with hydrogen engines for quite a while now. In fact, you can rewind the clock a little bit to 2021, when Toyota announced it was building a hydrogen engine to be showcased in the GR Yaris. Of course, the GR Yaris was kind of the perfect application to show that hydrogen engines aren't just for weenies that love great fuel economy and saving the environment, but also for people who love going fast and love the sound of internal combustion engines. The engine in the GR Yaris showcase car was basically just a G16E GTS, which we've made a video on recently. I'd highly recommend you go check that out. They pretty much just took that engine and modified the injection system for hydrogen fuel rather than gasoline. In fact, the experimental hydrogen-powered Corolla Sport had already been competing in the Super Taiku race series in Japan since earlier in 2021 under the rookie racing arm of Toyota Gazoo Racing. So Toyota was getting pretty experienced with hydrogen engines from using them in a few race cars. So it was time to scale it up to a larger engine, which is where the new hydrogen-powered 5-liter V8 comes into play. And much like the smaller hydrogen-powered 3-cylinder G16E GTS that we just talked about, this 5-liter V8 is based almost entirely on an existing Toyota engine, which is the 2UR FSE. Now, a lot of the news reports were saying that this hydrogen-powered engine was the RCF engine, but I think it's actually worth noting that the 2UR FSE is actually used in a lot more than just the RCF. You'll find it in the ISF, the GSF, the LC500, the IS500. Like, it's more than just the RCF engine. It is Toyota's performance 5-liter V8 that's in multiple applications. The 2UR is an all-aluminum dual overhead cam V8 with 4 valves per cylinder. Funny enough, the heads are actually designed by Yamaha and have some pretty cool features, including titanium intake valves, high-lift cams, a dual-length intake manifold system, dual VVTIE, and D4S injection, which is simply port direct injection combined together. The base engine in the RCF outputs 467 horsepower and 389 pound-feet of torque, which is pretty impressive for a naturally aspirated V8. For reference, Ford's 5-liter Coyote V8 engine in the Mustang produces 450 horsepower and 410 pound-feet of torque in its current configuration in 2022. Of course, with this new hydrogen-powered version of this engine, they had to make some changes. Most notably, they made changes to the injectors, heads, and intake manifold. The strangest change to me is that they reversed the flow of the heads. In all these photos shown by Toyota, this engine has a hot V design, meaning the exhaust manifold is in the V of the engine rather than the intake manifold being there, which means this engine will have two intake manifolds, one per side. Now, the showcase piece and the thing that everybody is talking about is the Yamaha-designed exhaust manifold, which is an 8-to-1 exhaust manifold and it's supposed to produce an incredible exhaust note, but unfortunately I can't show you that because they've actually yet to show this engine in video or sound, so we'll just have to wait and see how good it actually sounds. In terms of performance, they're claiming 455 horsepower at 6,800 RPM and 398 pound-feet of torque at 3,600 RPM, so it's a little bit down compared to the 2UR FSE that it's based on, but it's still a crazy amount of power naturally aspirated, especially considering it's outputting zero emissions. You might be wondering, why is Toyota even bothering this? Like, why bother investing in it? Why bother pushing this? Why bother marketing this when electric already has a substantial lead? Like, is hydrogen actually feasible? And the answer is no, but we'll get to that in a little bit. But Toyota has publicly stated that they're committed to the internal combustion engine, and it's something that they want to pursue long term, rather than electrifying their entire lineup like other manufacturers. And it's actually not just Toyota and Yamaha. It's also Mazda, Kawasaki, and Subaru, who have all pledged to continue investing in combustion engines and expanding fuel options beyond gasoline or diesel. Yamaha's president is pretty vocal about his belief in hydrogen and the combustion engine itself long term. He said, "Hydrogen engines house the potential to be carbon neutral while keeping our passion for the internal combustion engine alive at the same time. Teaming up with companies with different corporate cultures and areas of expertise, as well as growing the number of partners we have, is how we want to lead the way into the future. Hydrogen engines have an innately friendly feel that makes them easy to use without resorting to electronic driving aids. Everyone who came to test drive the prototype car would start off somewhat skeptical, but emerge from the car with a big smile on their face at the end. This is all part of becoming net neutral on carbon, or at least they say, by 2050. But the thing is, will this ever come to market? Maybe. Will it ever sell? No. If you look at previous attempts at hydrogen-powered cars, they did not end well. There is literally no demand for these cars at all. In fact, if you really want to disrupt the automobile industry, like if you look at Tesla, for example, if you want to change up what people are buying, you have to offer them a product that is superior in every single way to what you're currently offering. Hydrogen engines are not objectively better in almost every way compared to gas engines. They make a similar amount of power, they sound the same, and they have the same maintenance schedule. Like, they're very, very similar. You're just changing the fuel type. So there's no real reason to go buy hydrogen, especially considering the lack of infrastructure. So if you wanted to get fuel, unless you're in like Southern California or some parts of Europe, there's basically nowhere to get hydrogen fuel. So there's very few people who can actually fuel up these cars, so there's zero demand whatsoever. Electric, on the other hand, is almost silent, makes a ton of power, it's easy to drive, eliminates all maintenance costs, and more. As much as you and I both love tinkering on cars, fixing them, making them faster, breaking them, and then repeating the process, at the end of the day, electric cars are simply better. Electric cars might not be objectively better in every single way right now in 2022, but they will be in the near future. Really, the only thing that's stopping electric cars from being vastly better in every way is range and how long it takes to recharge them, but that's quickly changing, and 5 or 10 years from now, I have a hard time imagining that electric cars won't take over as the most popular cars being built and sold. So although it's really awesome to see Toyota and Yamaha investing in this, building this engine, you know, they did the G16e GTS, the hydrogen powered version of that, it sounds incredible, it's really cool, and I'm sure this 5-liter V8 will sound incredible, and it's very cool. There's almost no scenarios that I can think of where this will actually sell. It's really not that much better than their existing gasoline products, other than the fact that it outputs zero emissions, but most consumers truly actually don't care about that. They just want a good product. They want it to be fast, they want it to be reliable, and they want it to be cheap. Hydrogen is none of those things, but I want to know what you guys think. Let me know down in the comments below, do you think hydrogen is a viable alternative to gasoline or electric powered engines? Do you think Toyota's kind of crazy for pursuing this and just not letting the combustion engine die and going full electric like almost every other manufacturer is doing? Let me know down in the comments. While you're down there, smash the thumbs up button. It really helps out the channel. While you're down there, get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos. Check out the other videos on the channel. We have a ton of videos out there, and I'm sure you'll love all of them, and I'll see you guys in the next one.